हाय माँ, गुड मॉर्निंग, वेलकम फॉर टुडे सेशन. इन द लास्ट क्लास वी लर्न अबाउट वर्चुअलाइजेशन स्ट्रक्चर्स टूल्स. सो इन दैट वी हैव लर्न थ्री कैटेगरीज ऑफ वर्चुअलाइजेशन पॉसिबिलिटीज. वन इज होस्ट बेस्ड वर्चुअलाइजेशन, नेक्स्ट वन इज पैरा वर्चुअलाइजेशन, एंड द टॉप वन इज हाइपरवाइज्ड वर्चुअलाइजेशन, राइट. सो इन दैट वी लर्न अबाउट what is critical instructions, what are non-critical instructions, what is Zen hypervisor architecture for virtualization, what is domain zero, what is a domain U. Okay, so we discussed a lot of things in the previous classes. Today we are going to learn about how virtualization is going to be done in different computer hardware devices, in terms of a CPU, in terms of IO devices, in terms of a memory. So till now we learn about high level concepts, but we have to go a little bit in depth about this virtualization concept. Okay, so this virtualization can be happen in two ways, ma. Either we can execute directly in hardware devices, or we can do at the VMs only, right? So if the VM is going to be take care of everything from different guest OS, it's better. Okay, but whenever the hardware is going to be virtualization, the hardware is going to be supported this virtualization, we need some conversion by the OS, because the hardware is going to be under the control of the OS, right? Okay, so in that case, how it is happening, okay, what measures we have to be considered is going to be discussed here today, that is virtualization of CPU, memory and IO devices. Okay, so To support virtualization, a microprocessor called as a 8086. It's going to be on a running mode along with the instructions. Okay, so known as hardware assisted virtualization. 8086 multiprocessor previous days is going to use hardware virtualization, which contains a separate running mode along with the instructions to execute the virtualization concept. Okay, next, to save processor states, more switching is completed by the hardware only. See, processor states means what is happening here. So instead of everything is going to be requesting by to operating system, without disturbing the operating system, the hardware assisted virtualization only will take care of the any switching. Switching means from main memory to secondary memory, or from main instructions to local instructions, or any conversions will take care of by hardware virtualization concept only. So who is going to be supported this hardware virtualization? The two main companies, Intel and AMD, have proprietary technologies for hardware assisted virtualization. So these are the two most companies which given the hardware assisted virtualization concept. So what is the advantage with hardware assisted virtualization, ma? It will save time, because everything is under the control of the hardware only, right? Next, hardware support for virtualization. So how we have to support the hardware? Whatever, till now we didn't learn about the hardware support, right? Till now what we are learning, we have a guest OSs, we have a VMM, we have a hypervisor, so that the guest OSs and VM will take care of that. Whenever there is a need to conversion, either guest OS will convert or VM will take care of the conversion, right? Now it is a time to learn how hardware is going to be supported for virtualization, right? So in this, if there is no production mechanism in a processor, all instructions from different processors will access the hardware directly and cause a system call. See, if a hardware is not able to control the instructions coming from different OSs or guest OSs in terms of virtual machines, then it is tough to control the operations on the hardware, because actual data, the important data, is going to store in the hardware only. If you're not able to control that hardware, what it means, ma? The system will crash. So it here we have to think that any mechanism we have to be used for virtualization at the lower level should be at the hardware with a security manner. Okay, so for that, all processors have at least two modes. So each processor is not giving directly permission to access the hardware, but they are kept in two modes. One is a user mode, next one is a supervisor mode. The user mode is normal one. The supervisor one is the controlling one, where we can control, means we can update our data, we can change our data. So based upon the request we are getting from outside users in terms of guest voices or applications, we have to check their authentication and we have to set them whether they are going to be user mode or supervisory mode, okay, to save our critical hardware. So whenever the instructions, any instructions executed in supervisor mode, all called as a privileged instructions, of course. And other instructions are unprivileged instructions. If you remember at the time of virtualization introduction in the previous classes, we learned about four different type of virtualization, right? Normal one, normal operating system concept. Next one is the virtualization is going to be at the host OS. Next, at the second one is a guest at the guest OS. Third category is placing the virtualization at the both layers. One is at the guest OS and the host OS. Okay. If you are going to preferring giving preference to supervisor mode, whether it is a guest OS or a host OS, those instructions are called privileged instructions. Means we should not interrupt those instructions to execute. Right? Remaining one are unprivileged instructions. Example. So example is this one. This is the Intel architecture. The Intel company has given virtualization concept at the hardware level, where we can do virtualization happily at the hardware level only, instead of inserting at the VMM or at the guest OSs. If you observe here, we have a normal thing, our different OSs running at different VMs, right? And here that is our bare hardware or computer hardware. In order to control this processor by different VMs or applications, we have a virtualization technology called as a VTX or VTI. VTX or VTI. We will learn about this two, what they are doing. And next one is a memory, extended page table. So it is one which are going to use at the memory level, and I/O devices, which contains a direct memory access and interrupt, which contains a VTD and VTC respectively. VTD for the I/O devices direct access, and VTC for the network and storage concepts. Okay, ma? I repeat. VTX, VTI for the virtualization of processor, EPD for the memory, and VTD for the DMO and I/O device, and VTC for the network. Okay, ma? So these are the things, the virtualization concept implemented by Intel directly at the bare hardware of our computer system. Okay, so with this, with hardware assisted technique to make virtualization easy and improve performance. Okay. So the above diagram provides the overview of Intel full virtualization techniques. So the for processor virtualization, Intel offers the VTX or VTI technique. We just said previously, VTX adds a privileged mode. As I said previously, how many modes we have? One is a privileged mode, next one is a unprivileged mode. The VTX will add the privileged mode, okay, by which we can, any user can able to access and also can change the data. It is a VTX mode. Coming to the VTI, includes a series of extensions for hardware virtualization, which we given in the previous slide. The VTX extensions are probably the best recognized extensions because it is giving the privileged mode. Along with, they are adding some more features called as a migration, priority, and memory handling capabilities to a wide range of Intel processors. And VTD for, by comparison, the VTD extensions and virtualization support to Intel chipset that can assist I/O devices, which we learn, ma. VTD for the I/O devices and VTC for network and storage devices, right? And VTC extensions better virtualization support to I/O devices such as network switches. Okay, so this enhancement traps all sensitive instructions in the VMM automatically. Traps means whenever the VMM is running or guest OS of virtual machine under the control of VMM is running in super privileged mode or supervised mode, automatically all these instructions can be executed. Okay, and coming to the memory, EPT, extended page table. What is the need of this page table means? So in our computer we have a page table, right, in the OS also. What they are going to do, they are going to do from the logical address to physical address conversion. Okay, now it is a time to, we have a virtual address also here. The virtual address is the one which is going to be storing at the virtual machine. They don't know actual address, but they don't know about the virtual address only. That virtual address have to convert into actual physical address, and the physical address have to convert into the machine address, which can able to understood by the computer. Okay, all these bidirectional conversions, okay, all these binary conversions, we have two conversions. One is the virtual address to physical address to memory address, okay, machine address. So these conversions is going to be taken care of by extended page table map. We will see shortly about that. So for IO virtualization, Intel implements VTD and VTC to support. Now it is time to learn how the CPU virtualization is going to be. CPU is the one which able to execute our instructions, right? So in order to execute instructions, we have to take care of which one is giving instructions to execute, whether it's user mode or supervisory mode. Okay, so whenever the supervisory mode is executing privileged mode, automatically they have to control the devices, right? Now, so for this, in order to verify the CPU virtualization concept, we have two types of instructions: critical instructions, non-critical instructions. Critical instructions are the one which can trap the system, means non-maskable interrupt, by which we can't stir any instruction to execute. If that is the case, we have to take care of our computer in a secure manner. We have to verify from where this critical instruction is getting to modify our data. And coming to the other one, the non-critical instructions, so these are the non-secure instructions. They will not do any modification, thus they will execute their own part and they will go up. Okay, now see what will happen with the CPU virtualization. A VM is a duplicate of existing computer, we know about this, in which a majority of a VM instructions are executed on host processor in the native mode. So all those instructions are executed in our computer only, in our host device only. Okay, even though they can convert, who, even the virtual machine have a lot of applications and interfaces, but the actual instructions are executed in your computer only, right? That is our native mode. Thus, unprivileged instructions of VM can run directly on host machine for a higher efficiency. So all the instructions, whether it is a privileged or unprivileged, they are going to execute in our computer only. And other critical instructions should be handled carefully for correctness and stability. So what is it, ma'am? The critical instructions which is going to be non-maskable interrupt, we have to take care of that one, because they can change our data. In that case, we have to handle them very carefully. So these critical instructions are divided into three categories, ma. One is the privileged instructions, control sensitive instructions, and behavior sensitive instructions. How many we have? I repeat, privileged instructions, control sensitive instructions, and behavior sensitive instructions. The privileged instructions execute in the privileged mode and will be trapped if executed outside this mode. Yes, we can't max, we can't mask them, just we have to allow them to execute. Control sensitive instructions attempt to change the configuration of resources used. See, so this will try to change the configuration. The configuration has been changed, which is not maybe supported for your operating system, then what happens? You may suffer, right? Behavior sensitive instructions have different behaviors depending upon the configuration of the resources, including load, store, and operations. Okay, so they may behave differently or they may deviate from a normal operation, right? So these are the three categories of instructions of critical, ma. One is a privileged one, one is a control sensitive one, one is a behavior sensitive instructions, right? No need, ma, that one. Hardware assisted CPU virtualization. Now this hardware, how this hardware assisted is going to be using for this CPU virtualization, means how to these critical and non-critical instructions are executed in CPU, by CPU in hardware assisted concept. So this going to use either full or para virtualization concepts. So this technique attempts to simplify virtualization, because full or para virtualization is complicated. As we learn about the full or para virtualization, which is going to tough to execute, this will take care of this toughness and make us too easy. So further, again, the Intel and AMD processor will providing two concepts ma, one is the ring 0 and the ring 1 concept, right? So privileged mode level is called as ring 1, means we can control the privileged instructions by with the other instructions called as unprivileged one in terms of ring 1. We can classify them. Therefore, means privileged mode means different OSs. The virtual machine instructions can be called as a privileged one. Whenever the virtual machines are in the privileged mode, then their instructions are executed. Otherwise, our computer, that is non-privileged one, if they are in privileged one, our OS is a non-privileged one, then our so that the hardware is going to be assisted, whether we have to execute their or ours. Okay, therefore operating system can still run at ring 0 and the hypervisor can at ring 1, right? So this hypervisor means when a privileged mode is there by VMs, then it is called as a ring 1 and ours is a ring 0. So all the privileged and sensitive instructions are trapped in the hypervisor automatically. So we have to give preference to hypervisor only, that is virtual machine monitor only, we have to give the preference first. Example, if you see this diagram, so ring 0, that is us, ring 0, the ring 1 to up to ring 3 or ring 4, whatever, they are going to give us a privilege to the virtual machines. Right? If you observe here, the VMX, virtual machine extension root mode, is going to be a privileged mode. When with this, the virtual machine can able to control our memory or I/O devices. Okay, see this. All these are running under the control of this ring 0 only, that is our VS, that is our operating system. But whenever they are converted into the privileged mode, they are at the VMX root mode by the virtual machine and they can execute their instructions. Okay. Intel calls the privilege level of 8086 processor as VMX root mode. Okay. Zen, VMware and the Microsoft virtual PCs all implement their hypervisors by using the VTX technology. VTX. What is VTX? Virtual Technology X. Who is going to be given this? The Intel has given. For what? To perform virtualization. Where? The hardware only. At the hardware only. No need to give any intervention to the OS. But in the hardware only, they can change the instructions, types, do some modifications, binary translation. They can do all things. Coming to the last topic in this video, actually this is a very lengthy topic, so I divided this video in terms of two parts. Okay, so today I'm going to convey about the first part, that is memory virtualization. In the next part, we are going to learn about the IO virtualization. So virtual memory virtualization is similar to virtual memory support provided by modern operating system. Hope you remember the virtual memory in the OSs, which you learn in the OS operating system subject. So what is the virtual memory, ma? We have a very less memory, but lot of applications are trying to access this less memory. What the computer will do? They will do, whenever there is a free memory is there, they are going to be allocating to the required application so that the application is not going to stop their execution. So what they think? All the applications think that we have a lot of memory because their applications are executing. But what is happening inside the memory, ma? They are going to be managing the memory, giving access to different persons, right? So in a traditional execution environment, the operating system maintains mappings of virtual memory to machine memory using page tables. Yes, I hope you remember these page tables. What they will do? They will convert the virtual memory to physical memory, that is machine memory, which is a one stage mapping from virtual memory to machine memory, normal OS. But whenever there is a virtualization need, we have a called as memory management unit or translation lookaside buffer. So these two are the things which can able to support our virtualization conversion in two ways. So with this, this is no need. So that means a two stage mapping process should be maintained by guest OS and VMM respectively. How? Virtual memory to physical memory conversion and physical memory to machine memory conversion we need. Okay, so the guest OS continues to control the mapping of virtual addresses to physical memory addresses, and our OS will able to control the physical addresses to machine address conversions. Okay, but the guest OS cannot directly access the actual machine memory. So the VMM is responsible for mapping the guest physical address to the actual machine memory. So instead of our OS also, the VMM will take care of this conversion, two-way conversion, with the help of page tables. So VMM uses shorter page tables to perform this virtual machine memory to machine memory address translation by using translation look ahead buffer concept. If you observe here, we have a virtual machines and they have a lot of process are executing. Here they are going to use a virtualization address memory, but actually they are going to store at the physical memory in terms of some address, that is physical address. And finally, this address is going to be have to convert to the computer to locate the address permanently and get access of the instructions. That is going to be called as a machine memory address. Okay, so this is the extension page table conversion. If you observe here, we have a different levels of a computers, levels of a memories we have. Okay, in the guest OSs, so they have virtual address and they have virtual OS, that is a kernel we have. Okay, what is a GVAC here? Virtual address, address of a processor in guest OS, GVA. What is the GPM? Physical address of the guest OS. So this is a virtual machine and we have a layer, that is between you and virtual machine, we have a layer called as a virtual machine monitor, which will take care of all these conversions. Here extended page table we are going to use whenever there is a guest physical address conversion we need, this is going to be taken off by our extended page table or memory management unit. They will store the different addresses and conversions from this virtual to physical addresses. Okay, now so this is called as extended page table by given by Intel for memory virtualization. That's it, ma. That is for today. So in the next class we are going to learn this IO virtualization. Okay, ma. So bye for today.